The following is an excerpt from the novel Promo Cowboy by Barry Fitzsimmons, read by the author. Chapter 15. Don't take the job! That's what Willie says, too darn loud for the distance. Well, hey there, Will, I call out like I'm far off. Don't be shy, just come on in. Look here, Joe, it's old Willie, come to offer his regards. Joe don't even turn around. Willie, you owe me 50,000 bucks. Of course, Will don't seem to hear Joe. Don't even look at him, just at me. I'm serious, cowboy. This job, this position, you better say no. I sure don't want to let on how I know just what Willie's talking about. So I say, real sly-like, I ain't got no idea what you're talking about, Willie. I know you know, he says, with his hands on his hips like a woman. You and Belinda are planning something. Why else would you show up like you did last night? I can't help it but make a chuckle. What did that woman tell you? She wouldn't tell me anything, but I know how she thinks. She's setting you up, cowboy. Whatever job she offers, don't take it. Say no. It ain't up to you, little Will. And I'm telling you, Franklin, you wouldn't even know Belinda's name if it wasn't for me. Aight, I make a nod, hoping to keep my blood down. Grateful I am, Will, for the good word. Only ain't sure why you done it. Recommended me, I mean. I recommended you because you're freelance to the core, and I expected you not to get in the way. What I didn't expect, he puts a thumb against his glasses just like a little kid. It wasn't supposed to go like this. This is supposed to be my operation, with Belinda doing her part, and a little help on the side from Promo Cowboy. He looks at me accusatory-like. You were supposed to maintain proper distance, man. Shoot, Will, I've been on this gig less than a week, and already you're in over your head, and you're screwing me in the process. I feel my neck hairs all right. That's a darn insult, I say. I ain't screwing you or anybody else. You have no idea what's going on, cowboy. Listen here. No, he cuts me off, pointing his finger at my nose. You listen. You're supposed to deliver promos like you always do and stay away from Sam Ballot and all the rest of the suits, including Belinda. That ain't your call to make, Will. Cowboy, I'm serious. It won't be long before Belinda's out of the picture and I take my rightful position as Sandby's right hand. If you don't play this thing like I'm telling you, you're going to get hurt and you'll take me right down with you. And after that, who knows what'll... Willie looks over at Joe, who this time ain't faking it to look like he's busy. Instead, he's turned around in his chair, just plain listening. Say it, Joe tells him. Who knows what'll what? Will looks in my eyes. She's spreading out a big net for you and me to get tangled up in. She'll ruin us. There ain't no us to ruin, I growl. I mean business, cowboy. Think I don't? And think I won't bend you like a damn twig if you don't back off? I look over his shoulder, out the door and into the hall, where there's a clutch of young professionals gathered, witnesses to a skirmish. I lower my voice. Anyhow, maybe it's too late. Maybe the deed's already done, and can't nothing or nobody stop it. Ain't a lie, only it's awful close. Willie gets a fiery look on him, like I seen last night. This is my deal, cowboy. My ticket. I set this whole thing up, and Belinda, she's just... If she thinks she's... He of a sudden puts a hand up like he's committed a foul. This isn't over, he says. Then he's out the door and down that hall. I follow along like I'm showing him out. Have a nice day, I call out from that doorway. All them TSV regulars in that hall, they all look at me, straight like. I make a nod to them, only ain't one of them young folks nods back.